Hi dear children, how's the day? Hope you're all fine there. I'm also fine here. And the other day we were discussing with the first lesson in your main textbook Beehive that the name is The Fun They Have. Hope you remember where we have stopped. We have completed the lesson. Do you remember the story? What was the fun they had? Who were the main characters? There were two main characters, Margie and Tommy. And they were enjoying the fun of school centuries back, which we are practicing now. The school where there is a building named the school. There are some classrooms. Children are coming to the school and enjoying their life. Teachers are coming and taking the lessons. All those things that was really fun to Margie and Tommy. That's where the title of the name comes true. Now,
the other day we were doing on with some grammar portions. The first one was adverbs, and the question which I have given to you as a homework was, there were two questions. The first one was to find out the position of the adverbs given in the box from the text itself. That is very easily can be done by you. Page number 6 onwards it starts, and page number 8 it ends. Till there only all the adverbs are given, and it's given in the correct order also. You can write them down and understand the meaning. And now we'll go for the second exercise, and the answers, I'm going to read it, just the answers only. The first one's answer is carefully, the second one's answer is lawfully, and the third one's answer is differently, fourth one is sorrowfully, fifth one is completely, sixth one is nonchalantly, seventh one is awfully, and the last one, eighth, is quickly. Hope you are clear about all these exercises. If you have any doubt, you can ask me.
And the next one was, if not and unless. Hope you remember all those things. And now we will be going on with the next exercise.
A new revised volume of Isaac Asimov's short stories has just been released. Order one set. Write a letter to the publisher, Mindframe Private Limited, 1632, Asafali Road, New Delhi, requesting that a set be sent to you by value payable post, VPP, and giving your address. Your letter will have the following parts.
The question is very clearly given here. You are going to order a collection of books, and for that you are going to write a letter to the publishers. And that letter you have to write here, that's a formal letter. Hope you know the format of the formal letter. That will be the address of the sender, that is the from address. And here you have to write your name and other details. Right. And the next one will be the to address. There also you have to address the person who is maybe the manager, the publications, the name of the publication, you can say the HNC Publications, for example. That's a publication. The name of the publisher is HNC. Like that, there will be a lot of publications. Those publications' name you can write here, and the address very clearly to be given down. And between this, you must write the date. Between from and to, you must add the date. How you must write the date, that is very clearly given here. First you have to write the date, then you have to write the month, and then you have to write the year. This is very clearly given in your text itself. This format must be followed by you very clearly. And then comes the salutation that is already given here. Dear sir or ma'am. Then comes the body part, what you have to say there. Yeah, I came to know that in a new short story collection of Isaac Asimov has been released recently, and I would like to have a copy of it. I request you to send me to the given below address. I will be collecting it as VPP. What is VPP? Value paid by post. Once when the item is received by us, we will be paying it on the spot. Not before receiving the item. That's what is VPP. That's what we are going to write in the body part. We are not going to extend it too much. We will be briefing it to the point only. I will be thankful to you for sending the copy. I will be paying it by VPP. That's what will be the content. And then comes the closing note. Yours faithfully. Yours sincerely. Yours sincerely is given here. You can use either yours sincerely or yours faithfully. Don't say yours lovingly, because this is not a personal letter. This is a formal letter. The ends the letter. And towards the end, you have to write your signature and your name. That part is clear for you, I think. And now we will go for the next exercise. That is a speaking exercise. This is about a debate. Here it is said to be conducted as a group activity. But that is not very easy for us, as we are locked in our house because of COVID-19, the epidemic. Now listen, what we can do is that each of you can prepare 2 to 3 points either for or against. What is the topic?
The debate topic is the schools of the future will have no books and no teachers.
The future schools will have no books, no teachers, whether it is good or bad. That is the question. If you feel that this is good, then you can choose 3 points. You can make the arguments clearly and can present it as a voice note to me in the interaction time. Hope you are clear about it. Okay. And if you are not agreeing with it, also the same thing you have to do. Prepare 3 points. Write them down. Make it down. It must be there in your notebook. That's why I am telling you have to write it down. And then you have to record it as an audio and send it to me. When we are going for an interaction, that time you have to send it to me in WhatsApp. Hope you are clear about it. Now we'll be going on with the next exercise. That's a project.
Here you can read the project question. Nowadays, use of digital devices has increased and digital services have made our cash transactions easier and smoother. Government of India has taken initiatives to digitalize cash transactions to buy things and pay bills. Following are some of the digital initiatives to make people use digital services. Take up a project in groups of our to collect opinions of people on the use of digital services in their daily life. Develop an opinionnaire to collect opinions of about 40 people in your neighborhood. Divide the work among four to collect the opinion. Fabulate the ideas and write a report about the use of digital devices. Once the project is completed, each group may present it to the whole class. Charts may be created and displayed on the notice board. This is all about the question here. Here it says very clearly to express your opinion simply by collecting the details from the neighborhood people. You are expected to collect from 40 neighboring people and to take the responsibility divided equally by 4 students. But that's not very easy for us. So what you are expected to do is to collect from your neighboring people. You can collect from minimum 5 to maximum 10 people. Gather the information, make it as a project and submit it during the reopening day. That's what you can do now.
Okay, we are going to the project. First of all, before starting the project, you have to prepare a questionnaire. Hope you remember how you have to go for a survey. If you don't know, I will say, before a survey, you have to prepare a questionnaire. That will be including all the questions which we have to know the details of. What all details we have to know, all the details we have to include in the questionnaire. But you must be making it into brief. Make sure that you are preparing a questionnaire and then you have to go to the neighboring houses. The simplest way is to prepare some questions by which you will get all the details from the neighboring people. You go there, collect the details, but it's very sure this is corona time, the epidemic spreading is everywhere. So better you don't go there, better to make a phone call, collect the information, pen it down, and then later make it together into a project. Hope you are clear about it. Anyhow, some questions must be there, but it's not compulsory to have a questionnaire. A questionnaire, preparing a questionnaire is making too much of time, so that's not compulsory. Instead of that, you can prepare some small questions so that we'll understand it very clearly how we can analyze whether it is helpful or whether it is an addiction. A very simple question. How much time are you using mobile phone? That's a simple question actually. When we are listening to their answers, we can very clearly understand whether the people are addicted to the mobile or not. How long are you sitting in front of a computer other than for working time? That is the thing. Whether they are working or not, that we cannot think. If they are working, if they are working from home and all, that time they have to spend 5 or 6 hours, maximum 8 hours they will have to spend for working. That we cannot deny the fact. And other than that, how long they are depending upon their mobile, computers, laptop and other things. That is the first question which you can ask to your neighbors and your family, friends, all those people, to make sure whether they are addicted to it or not. If they are not using it for a long time, it is very sure that they are not addicted to it. But most of the people in our surroundings, we can make it very sure that they are always with the mobile phones. You can see it while walking also, people will be playing on the mobile, watching something, and they'll be having headset on their ears, listening to music, listening to all the audios, videos and all those things. They'll be using it. Most of the people around us are using it. And we can say that many of the people in our surrounding, they are actually addicted to it. We cannot say that they are using it for simply for the purpose. But instead, we have to say that they are using it as they are addicted to it. Hope you are clear about it. Thank you. Have a nice day.